Hey, welcome back to Fix It in Post. My name is Nick, and today we're gonna look at how to rig an arm in After Effects using a really fun and free script called Duik, Bassel. Now, Duik has been around for a while, and quite frankly, is one of the best character rigging tools for After Effects, and the fact that it's free is even more mind-blowing. Speaking of awesome things, check out our sponsor, the Lyric Video Creator Kit. 20 text templates to supercharge your motion graphics in Premiere. Link in the description. Okay, first up, you're gonna have to download the script. Go to the link in the description and download Duik Bassel. Once you've downloaded it, install it into your script UI panel in After Effects. On a Mac, you can find it here under the app itself. I can only assume it's the same on a PC. Next, load up After Effects and boot up the script by going to Window and clicking on Duik Bassel. Here, it'll prompt you about a few things. Just don't forget to pick the correct language. And if you mess up, don't worry. Just go to the wrench icon in the corner, select the language you want here, and then apply the changes. Now, let's get rigging. So once you've loaded up Duik, let's click on this armature thing here, or the rigging icon if you like. And there we go, we've got here. And so there's a whole bunch of things you want to check in here, but we're sort of, you can do that in your own time. I'm just going to show you specifically how to rig an arm, so it's not too hard. So let's see, we've got a arm here and we've got the bicep, the forearm and the forearm and the hand. So as you can see here, the bicep is rigged at the shoulder, the pivot point is at the shoulder, the forearm is a pivot point at the elbow, and the wrist is the pivot point for the hand. And the hand is parented to the forearm is parented to the bicep, as you would imagine. So let's select all these from top to bottom, so bicep, forearm, and then hand. And then I select this where it says arm or front leg, and let's see what happens. And right now, as you can see right here, the bones are actually, see the top of this bone here is actually exactly where the pivot point is for the shoulder. This bone here, which is the forearm, is pivoted exactly to where the pivot point is for the elbow. And this last one here is pivoted to where the wrist is. So that's really great. But as you can see, if we do start moving the bones, it's not connected to any of these bones. So we have to actually connect them ourselves. I'm just gonna pull this out just a little bit here. So we're just gonna parent the bicep to the arm, and then parent the forearm to the forearm, and then the hand to the hand, and we won't worry about the tip. Now, that's fine now, and so what we're gonna do is we're gonna select all these bits, and we're gonna go back to the rigging here, and then we go to this second one, which is the links and constraints, and we're just gonna press auto rig IK. And once you click that, it'll give you a hand control, which is right there. Now, what's great about this hand control is you've got a few options here. And what I like to do is go to the effects control here and you can find the icon, pull down menu, and then we can make the handle a little bit bigger, and then we'll push it off to the side. And what's great is that now that it's off to the side, it's not kind of interrupting your flow here. So you can actually move your arm around and just drag that thing. And this is just a guide handle. So as you can see here, it comes up as a guide. So this will not render in your final render, or if you put it into a pre-comp, this will not come through your pre-comp at all. So that's really good. And this is all keyframeable. Yeah, and you can move things around. You can also reverse for whatever reason. So it is going in the right way right now in terms of like the IK happens to be going the right way. But if it's not, you can just select the reverse checkbox here and it'll actually bend in the opposite direction if you want that as well. I like to turn off the so if I go down to display, I like to turn off the draw guides, and I also like to turn off the actual bones themselves so you can't see them. So it is just this moving around by itself, and that is kind of cool. Now, I also, as a preference, don't like it when it stretches like this. Like, I don't like when it does this. So what I do is I tend to turn that off. So if you go to stretch and go auto stretch and turn that off, now it won't. So if it overextends, it'll just stay within the proportions of what you've told it to do, which is fantastic. And so now you can just start animating your IK rig as you would like. All right, well, that's rigging an arm in a nutshell. I'll be posting more rigging tutes later this year. I'm thinking a face one, maybe how to select different hands, change clothes, you get the deal. Also, if you're not subscribed, why don't you do that right now? And one last thing, I want to show you this meme I saw about artists, and this 100% exactly is how I am all the time. Do you guys feel the same? Comment, let me hear, and I'll see you guys next time.